Hello friends, so today we'll be discussing about the critical section problem. So let's say we have n processes from P1 to PN, and each of these processes are accessing some shared variables or updating some common files or some DB tables, etc. And in that case, if they are accessing these variables together, then something wrong can happen. Like if it is trying to print the value, then it could have been updated by some other function. So these kind of things can happen. So let's say we consider an account balance variable and two functions, deposit and withdraw. And deposit does a couple of steps and withdraw does a couple of steps. And let's say it is doing these steps, but in between this withdraw process starts, then it can interfere with the functionality of this process. Okay, so these things can happen if we don't exclude the execution of this function from the execution of this function. So for this, whatever portion of a function or a process is executing some code which acts on common variables or some shared things, then we call it the critical section. So let's say we have a process, and this is the critical section for the process. And we can have two more sections above and below. One is called the entry section, and below it we might have a exit section. And after it we can have our remainder code, remainder section or remainder code. So this is the whole structure of a process. And there can be a separate process which can be having its own critical section. So what we need to take care is these two processes can't be in their critical sections together. So when a process P1 is trying to enter its critical section, in the entry section, it sends a request to all other process that, okay, I am going to now enter into my critical section. None of you can be in their critical section now onwards. And when in their exit section, it again sends a permission to all of these processes that, okay, I am done with my critical section. Please feel free to access your critical section. But they won't access their critical section directly. They will obviously send a request to all of the processes and just make sure that nobody is in their critical sections, and then they will execute it. So how this exclusion, how this request and responses are sent, the requests and the permissions here, they are sent, how this whole thing is taken care, that is taken care through a lot of protocols which are solving this critical section problem. We'll discuss these as we go forward in the lectures. Thank you, friends.